guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sachi Bhaseen Daga. So if you're new here, this is my little home here on YouTube. So welcome. And for the rest of you, thank you so much for joining me. I am so excited to have you once again on a very fun video. For today's video, I am doing product empties. So this video, I personally love watching because it actually gives me an insight as to which skincare is actually good or which hair care or items that people can't live without. So it really gives me a good idea as to what to invest in. And today I have a lot of products that I want to talk to you, and I'll try to be as quick as possible. I'm going to be showing you product empties, so the ones that are totally over, and whether I'm going to be repurchasing them again or not. So without further ado, let's just get started. First product I want to talk to you about is the Estee Lauder Perfectly Clean Multi-Action Foam Cleanser. This is what it looks like. This is in fact my second face wash that is totally empty. I honestly love this. I will be repurchasing this again. And also, all the products that I'm going to be talking about is going to be linked down below in the description box, so don't worry. This beautiful cleanser, oh my god, I can like rave about this for hours, but I really like it. It strips away any kind of excess dirt or grime or makeup that has been left over after you clean your face with a makeup remover. It really cleanses it, really deep cleanses it. I sometimes also just use it as a mask. So I take a lot of product and I rub it with my fingers and I just kind of apply it as a mask, leave it on for 5 minutes and wash it, and it really cleanses the face. Oily skin types, you will love this. I am dry to combination, but I still use this because the way it removes my makeup, especially in the night, before sleeping, using something like this is absolutely amazing, and then going ahead with a heavier moisturizer. So this I will be repurchasing. This is my first product empty, and something so exciting about actually finishing a product, it just makes you feel so satisfied. My second product that I want to talk about is my moisturizer. So this is the L'Occitane Immortal Press Use Moisturizer. I am almost over with it. As you can see, there's just probably one or two more days of day and night moisturizing left. This is a very heavy moisturizer, so you dry skin types will absolutely love this, especially during winter. I think I'll be repurchasing this during the winter months because it's a very heavy cream. I also see myself using this in the night because it really moisturizes and I feel it's doing the job. It's a really good cream. I have really enjoyed wearing this, especially now when I'm at home. It is really working for me because I apply this before my makeup and all of that. Really, really like this. It is an expensive product, so I'm going to hold on to my repurchasing this right now. The moisturizer that I'm currently using is the Estee Lauder Day Wear Moisturizer, so I'm really liking that and I'm using that for the night as well. But this one I'm going to probably repurchase in the winter season when I really require that heavy moisturizing for my dry to combination skin type. Moisturizer that I want to quickly talk about, which I've just recently emptied and I discarded it unfortunately, was the Ultra Facial Cream by Kiehl's. I really, really like this. I think this goes for a lot of skin types. I'm going to insert a picture somewhere here. It's a really, really nice moisturizer. Right now I do have the Day Wear by Estee Lauder, so once I complete that, I will go ahead and purchase the Ultra Facial Cream for sure. It really works well for me and it's a beautiful formula that's it feels really moisturizing, like it really does a great job in hydrating the skin. So if you haven't tried that, I highly, highly recommend you give that a go. Let me know if you have down in the comments below. I want to quickly come to lip balm. I'm almost done with this. This is the Kiehl's Butter Stick Lip Treatment. It has SPF 25 and it also has a beautiful like nude in it. This is, I mean, it's almost done. So I'm going to quickly swatch it in the back of my hand so you can see. It's a very light sheen of a nude color. Really have enjoyed wearing this and I am repurchasing this for sure because it has SPF 25. It has a beautiful sheen. So whenever you want a good lip care situation happening, this is absolutely beautiful. I love how moisturized my lips feel and the color that it gives it. It's very everyday, you know, just stepping out to go grocery shopping or to meet a friend or anything of that sort. You really don't want something too makeup-y. This should be a very good option. Also, it really nourishes the lips. I use this during the day, I use this at night before sleeping, and I will go ahead and repurchase this hands down. Next product that I've surprisingly finished two of these is the Pond's Vitamin Micellar Water. So I'm a little confused about how I feel about this. I really enjoy this for removing, you know, sometimes when I do eyeshadow swatches and things like that, I just want any like affordable micellar water that I can just use without feeling like, oh my god, like I shouldn't waste this. For example, the one that I use all the time for my makeup remover is the Belief Herb Cleansing Water. As you can see, I'm almost halfway through. This is an amazing cleansing water, and it really makes your skin feel great after you remove it. It doesn't feel like dry or like icky. It really is amazing, and it is great for sensitive skin, which I have. So I really like this. You can check it out. I'm going to link it down below, so don't worry. But this Pond's Vitamin Micellar Water, I think I'll just be repurchasing this for, you know, sometimes when your lip color goes wrong or you want to retry a lip lipstick or something of that sort. This is a really good affordable option to have, and it's just nice to have it around when, suppose, your main makeup remover gets over and you're in the need of like an affordable option. I really like this. One that I really enjoy is the Hydrating Aloe Vera one. This is quite good. It also removes the face makeup well. The eye makeup, not so well. There's still, especially your mascara, it doesn't do the job as well. But for that, I will definitely recommend the Belief Herb Cleansing Water. Once this gets over, I will definitely repurchase this one. And this I will just have a cup because of all my swatches and being so heavily into makeup, I desperately need this around. Next up, I finished actually a setting mist, and this is the Morphe Times Jeffree Star one. I think you've seen me using this in a lot of my IGTV makeup tutorials. This is finally over. I will repurchase this when I go abroad. I don't know when I'm going to be traveling next, but when I go abroad, I will be repurchasing this. But I don't see myself going out of hand and ordering it online. I don't see it like as a breakthrough product or as a must-have. It's a nice product if you manage to go to Sephora and you just pick it up. It's quite nice. I'm not gonna really repurchase this ASAP. In fact, the setting mist that I really like is the Urban Decay All Nighter. That is something that whenever I travel, I have to pick up like one or two backups. So I have the dewy one, which I'm gonna be using. I also saw that Nykaa has the Flower Beauty Resetting Mist that they've recently released. So I'm definitely gonna be trying that out. But this, I'm not gonna be repurchasing again. Product that I don't see myself repurchasing again is the Victoria's Secret Temptation Fragrance Mist. I used to hoard these, like this particular line of mists. I used to hoard these, but now I'm just pretty much done with the scent, and I think it could be expired by now because the scent is just, it's just not doing its job anymore. So I am not liking this anymore. In fact, I really enjoy the Bath and Body Works fragrance mist. The one that I really enjoy is the one in gingerbread. It just gives that holiday feel, and I just love that. It just takes me to Christmas and like good times. So that's what I'm using now. This Victoria's Secret one, I am not going to be buying again. I'm going to talk about another skincare product. I know this is like in total randoms because this is what I have used up, and this I will be buying again. This is the Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair. As you can see, I am almost done. There's just a little bit left, but this will last me, I think, another 1.5 weeks. So I will be buying this again. I really enjoy this as a night care routine. For me, using makeup every day, I do not compromise on skincare. I think it's something that you have to be very, very particular about. And this, ever since I've been using this, my skin feels hydrated. It has this inherent glow, and it really does a good job. So it is an expensive product. They have different sizes, so you can check this out. This one was, I think, 5,600 or 5,900. I have to check. I'll just mention it down below here. But they have different sizes, so you can definitely buy a smaller size and try it out. But this has lasted me around 3 months, and I've been using this every day. Also for my makeup classes, which I've been conducting, a 7-day makeup class, I have used this for those as well. And I was doing makeup classes twice a day, so I was definitely using this because I recommend this to my students as well. And this is a really nice formula. It is very, I would say the reason why I love this is because it just absorbs in the skin immediately. It doesn't give that oily finish. So even oily skin types, you can definitely be rest assured this is a great product. I really enjoy this. It's very easy to function. It has a pump like this and it's just a very, very good product. I recently tried out Aveda's Cherry Almond Softening Shampoo. This, I bought two of them and this is the second one that just got over. I bought it together because the big size one wasn't available. This is quite nice. I've used this today for my shampooing. It's really, really nice. It's a softening shampoo. That's what really intrigued me when I purchased this. I do see myself buying this again, but I will buy it in some time because right now I am using the Moroccan Oil Hydration Shampoo and Hydrating Conditioner, which I love. It's really doing well for my hair during the summer months. But this I will probably purchase again towards winter when my hair feels much more drier. Right now my hair is already just generating oil, so it just needs something hydrating. But during the winter months when my hair needs that extra softening or that extra moisture, I will go ahead and purchase this again. It definitely did me good, but I think this will suit my hair towards the end of the year. But it is a really, really nice shampoo and they have these really cute travel friendly and travel size ones. So when you want to try it out, it's affordable and you can definitely try it out. Okay, talking about something I will purchase again is this Masaba by Nykaa Nail Enamel Remover. Oh my god, you guys, this is actually revolutionary. I had never tried one of these opening and just putting your finger in and swirling it and then it comes out and it's totally removed. So this is the first of its kind. I know there are a lot of makeup remover, nail polish removers like this, but this I really enjoyed. I mean, this really removes your nail polish effortlessly. It's just a no-brainer. I really enjoyed this. I definitely will be repurchasing this. This is just going to be an essential now in my vanity and it looks really pretty. That's just an add-on. I've also given my review on the lipstick, so in case you want to see that, I have that down below in the description box. The Masaba lipsticks and their nail colors as well. So when I received the Masaba collection, they had sent me this, and ever since they sent me this, I've been repurchasing this almost every 2 months because this is so good, such an essential product. Talking about nail products, this nail polish is one of my favorites. This is over. It's very dried out right now and I have just placed an order for another one. You can still see the color. It's such a pretty pink color. Whenever I wear this nail color, I get so many compliments. Everybody's like, what's on your nails? And it just gives a beautiful shine. This is the Nykaa Nail Enamel and this is in the shade Footstool 262. I love this color. This is such a beautiful patent color. For me, when I have my shoots, when I have meetings, when you're out and about, especially for working girls, this is such a beautiful color because it just looks natural, it looks healthy, and it doesn't look overwhelming. It goes with every outfit. So I will definitely be repurchasing this nail polish. I have two products more to talk about. This is looking really used because it is. This is the Kiehl's Actively Correcting and Beautifying BB Cream. This just looks bad. I'm so embarrassed to show you guys this, but it has been loved. It's been a very loved product and I will be repurchasing this. This BB cream has SPF 50. It does such a beautiful job in just giving a very effortless, you know, natural look. It's like a tinted moisturizer almost, but it has vitamin C, it has SPF 50, which is great for every day. I usually just put this on with a little bit of concealer. Today I have the Nykaa BB cream on. I'm quite impressed with the coverage. I have it around my face and my forehead, and under my eyes I have the Too Faced Born This Way concealer just to add a little more coverage. So I'm really liking that as well. It's a very affordable BB cream, which I will keep, you know, having in my vanity. But this is something that I just can't live without, because the days where I feel like my skin is breaking out or my skin isn't feeling the best, and but you still want a little bit of coverage, this is great because you know it's doing the job for you, and it just does wonders. I swear by this product. The last product that I want to talk about is the Nykaa Wanderlust in Japanese Cherry Blossom. This is a body wash, a shower gel, which I really like. This smells so good. Oh my god, and I can't believe I hadn't tried this line before. I just finished like my Nivea body wash. I was so basic. But I wanted to try something that really smells like very feminine and pretty. So I ordered the Wanderlust Japanese Cherry Blossom and I really like this. This has just been around a month old, but I've been using this a lot. It's halfway through and I just love using body washes. I already have a backup of this, and when that gets over, I will 100% order this again. This just is my patent smell. If you want to know what I smell like, this is what I smell like. That was just random, but this is a really good scent, and I will be repurchasing this. So that is it for my product empties of the, I would say, of the last 2 months. I've been really enjoying these products. The ones that I didn't like, you know it, I will not be repurchasing them again, but I'm glad I gave it a shot. I hope this was helpful to you, and let me know which products you cannot live without. I would love to give it a go. And also my lipstick, I know this question is going to come in the comments, so I'm going to quickly tell you, I am using the Matte to Last by Nykaa in the shade Naughty New. This is their mini lipsticks. Oh my god, this is such a pretty color. This is a beautiful shade, and it's really hydrating, and I love the mini version. It's super affordable. Link it down below, so don't worry. But thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Let me know what you want to see next. Bye.